Hi, I'm Barb Anderson.
Hi, I'm Ava Stafford.
Hi, I'm Meganne Stafford.
What is your connection to St. Paul's? When and how did you become a member?
I've been a lifelong member, as were my parents, my grandparents, and actually on my dad's side, we go back to founding members of St. Paul's.
So that also makes me a lifetime member. And when I attended St. Paul's School, my grandmother was actually my third grade teacher as well.
My great-grandma Eleanor taught here. My two grandparents, Barb and Jem, are members of the church, and so is my mom. And I've just been a member since I was born.
What does your involvement look like, or what has it looked like through the years?
So, as a lifelong member, I did all of the things that you do as a church member. I attended Sunday school, vacation Bible school, confirmation. After confirmation, I taught Sunday school for a couple years. And then once I was married, it was really important for me and my husband to make sure that we made church a priority because we knew that we wanted our children to be involved in St. Paul's too.
Sometimes at Saturday services, I'll usher here with my grandparents or play the piano. I've also been involved in cherub choir and Friends of the Lord choir, and I am currently in the school choir, so I've just sang here at Sunday services and just kind of volunteered.
And I've been a Sunday school teacher. I've served on several boards. Currently do home communions. I do a lot of baking and that kind of stuff for the church. And just, you know, we've been involved in some of the study groups.
Is there a favorite or memorable moment that sticks out from the past?
One of my most memorable moments was when I took my first communion class at the church in the spring of 2019. And I also love going to youth group there once a month, which I actually just got done with.
Yeah. I think youth group is always fun. That's probably something that's part of my favorite memories of growing up in St. Paul's, too. You know, the big United States youth gathering, and then in junior high and high school, we had a couple smaller gathering trips to Des Moines, and so getting to go there with friends was always a good memory. More currently, I think probably some of the favorite memories that I'm developing now are watching my oldest child perform in cherub choir, you know, getting to see her wear the same little red robes that I did when I was in cherub choir, and actually being directed by the same phenomenal choir director, Karen Dickman. It's very fun to see it through different eyes.
I would agree that youth group was probably one of the most memorable. Pastor Trachty, PT, and the Wartburg community knows him as, was pastor at St. Paul's the year that the youth gathering was held in New York City. And he was a fairly new minister, and so it was a great learning experience for all of us and one that we still reminisce about today. I would say probably the fact that we were married at St. Paul's. Meganne was married there. Well, my grandfather married us, as did PT. They did the service together, so that was really important.
What is your favorite aspect of St. Paul's in the present? Is there a particular event or ministry that sticks out?
One of my favorite things about St. Paul's is all the awesome things that I get to do. Like I said, there's multiple choirs, youth group, and communion. When I get older, I'll be able to do confirmation, get to go more to more youth gatherings and different places with those groups, and just so much more that I'm so excited for, and I can't wait.
I think one of the things that we've enjoyed as a young family are the family-focused services that they've started doing during Lent. You know, it really helps the kids to connect to their faith and building and enjoy the service. And I also really love that both of my kiddos that are attending St. Paul's get to know Deb, get to know the pastor. They see them involved in school on a weekly, if not daily, basis. I think that's super important to promote a good relationship with the pastor and the other leaders in the church. And it's an opportunity for the kids to really have and grow a good relationship with the pastor.
Yeah, and Deb will sometimes come up to our rooms for religion a couple Mondays a month, have some fun games.
Mm-hmm. I think the school has always been an important part and continues to be. But St. Paul's does a lot of different kinds of outreach sorts of things, whether it's the community dinner at the end of the month. There's always an awareness of where there's a need, whether it be LSI or Friends of the Family or other, you know, action groups around the community. St. Paul's has always been involved, and the steeple-to-steeple between Wartburg and St. Paul's is an important connection, too, as well as, you know, with Bartles and some of those other groups, that you can be as involved with any of them as you want to be.
What are your hopes and dreams for St. Paul's and its ministries?
Some of my hopes and dreams for St. Paul's are that they'll get more students in the school and more members of the congregation, because I just think it's such an awesome place. I also hope that they'll be able to do more fun activities in the future and more just educational field trips.
Mm-hmm. I would agree with that, Ava. I think it's important, and we want to continue to see St. Paul's grow and thrive. I would love to see larger classes at the school, and even to see some of the student ministry opportunities grow and continue. You know, like my mom said earlier, there's a lot of community impact from our church, but giving the youth of the church an opportunity to make an impact in the community, I think, would be something I'd love to see grow.
What has been the most meaningful experience at St. Paul's, and how has this experience transformed the life you currently live?
One of my most meaningful experiences at St. Paul's was when we went to Ewout Lou at the beginning of the school year. Another full meaningful experience was when I first got to volunteer at VBS Vacation Bible School this summer. I just love helping kids.
I would say, you know, growing up in the church, I've seen and been a part of all different milestone occasions and events, you know, weddings, funerals, baptisms, first communions, and then, you know, within the school too, baptismal remembrance, getting to leading worship. I was married here as well, and I had the honor of Pastor Trochte marrying us, and he was also who married my parents in St. Paul's. I think to be a parent now in the congregation and getting to see my children taking part in the ministries and milestones with Christ in their hearts is really special. St. Paul's is a tradition for my family.
I would say that probably the teachers that I had when I was at St. Paul's, I shared at the grandparent service that my first grade teacher would remind me for as long as she lived, it didn't matter whether she was at church or when she lived at Bartles, that I had always told her I was going to be a teacher. And how excited she was when I finally got to that point.
Is there a funny story that pops into your head when you think back to memories shared in our church and school?
One funny memory that pops into my head when I think about St. Paul's is how in kindergarten at lunchtime we would always kind of race each other to sit next to Kaya, the therapy dog that we had for a while. And another funny memory that pops into my head is Iwalu for various reasons.
I think going back to junior high and high school youth groups, those are probably some of my favorite memories as a youth at St. Paul's. I do know, you know, when we were in junior high, we got to do lock-ins at different churches. And one time at our church, we were playing sardines. And, of course, one of the boys had chosen to use the parish hall bathroom as the hiding spot. And so by the end of the sardines game, there were probably 25 of us crammed into this little bathroom. And when our youth leader at the time, you know, kind of found us and ended the game, I just remember her sitting there and just shaking her head because I'm sure it did not smell the greatest in there. And it's dark and we're all crammed in this little bathroom off the stage.
Yeah, that's why Deb always goes over the rule. No hygiene in the bathrooms.
I think I remember doing musicals at St. Paul's, and for some reason, I can specifically remember this one, and it was called A Hootenanny. And even yet, I can get that little tune going in the back of my head. But we just had so much fun costuming and learning the parts and just how important it was to be on stage and perform.
And right now in music class, we're actually getting ready to do our spring musical. So it's very fun.
Would you share how your faith has formed or transformed through the years, and how has St. Paul's fostered that transformation?
God's very important to me for a lot of reasons. I feel it's important to believe in God and fulfill His will on earth. Like in the Lord's Prayer, it begins by saying, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name." Then it says, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven." Another reason God is so important to me is because I can talk to Him whenever I need to, and even though I may not see Him standing by me, I know He's there every single step of my faith journey. I'm also glad that my parents sent me to St. Paul so I could continue to grow in my faith. I think that when I go to the middle school next year, I will really need God in my faith, so I'm glad I have those two things. Even as I get older, I'll still continue to come to church every Sunday so I can just sing and worship Jesus and God.
I would say that just having that constant there and knowing that church has been a part of life ever since I was born, it's just my parents always instilled, you know, God loves you, Jesus loves you. And then just being able to interact with others and take part in the activities at church has only reinforced that belief.
No, I think I've always had a security and known that God loves us and He walks with us every day of our lives. He's caring, forgiving, and loving, and that there's nothing that He does not have His arm around. Yeah. I think knowing that, you know, God's not there to take away the hardships or the pain or the tears, but He's always there to help guide us through the challenges in our lives. And St. Paul's has always been home and welcoming me in every part of my journey in faith.